Blind pick to Grand Arena, first match of the day, Tempo Storm versus The Move. This is an elimination series, folks.
Okay, we know him, Alec the Strategist. He's going to be playing Fire Mage, Armsware, Holy Paladin to try and counteract what they expected, the Shadow Priest Rogue. Let's see how effective it actually is. Alec bursted down immediately off the back of this opener, already overlapping heavy cooldowns on the side of Tempo Storm. But now they will be able to get aggressive towards Whiskey, securing a full Polymorph and stunning up the Shadow Priest. Now they just need the damage. They have to force a dispersion with this Polymorph and Rookie, but I'm not sure they're going to even get it.
The Move had such a good opener, and Poike used Trinket Sacrifice as well as that Blessing of Protection. Now Alex in a lot of trouble with the Fear on Poike. Alex getting lower and lower, spamming out the Polymorph. He gets Windjeared. Nicely done by Astro. Is this going to be the Cauterize and Ice Block? Cheap shot him, and Poike Cauterize is used as well as the Ice Block. The Move is destroying Tempo Storm.
These hexes from Absurge have been so critical to just locking Poike, the healer for Tempo Storm, out of the game, and they could just close the match with it. Windjeared onto the Polymorph. Absurge gets Dragon's Breath away, but will Alex survive? He blinks one shadow where death connects. Alec is hiding behind the pillar, but that Shadow Crash sneaks around the corner. Peekaboo moves in. There's almost absolutely nothing left to keep Alec going, and he will fall in game number one. Strategy torn apart by pure experience.
That is the Move that was dominant in NA. That is what NA has to offer. Starting off the day with a victory, and you can see Peekaboo getting hyped up on the stage right now. This is exactly what North America needed. North America needs to come out in this tournament, period. Otherwise, BlizzCon is going to be more in EU's favor than ever before, actually bringing more teams. They'll have five instead of just having four and four, Van.
Yeah, that was an incredible game by The Move. They just picked apart Poike, making sure they were baiting out defensive cooldowns. They knew exactly what they needed to do, causing major overlap in Tempo Storm. You can really just see Tempo
Storm. This game, very, very fast-paced matches, and I mean, we can see it right here. They have such great mastery of this composition, and you can tell that
so many interrupts for the Shadow Priest WizK, but obviously, Walrix has way more experience on Affliction Lock than Alec on his Affliction Warlock. So, not firing shots, I'm just saying purely based on experience, we're gonna have to wait and see if WizK can get the better of Alec in this exchange.
We're gonna have to see if the composition's gonna be enough for Tempo Storm to move on fire here, and I have a feeling WizK isn't gonna care about these pummels at all.
Peekaboo moving in, same opener, gets a sap onto Nixie, Garrote onto Alec. This is very similar to what we saw against XRB. Kidney shot him in Poike, putting out a lot of pressure as WizK moves in. All three members of The Move looking to get aggressive very early on. Kidney shot into silence, and Poike is going to gate away on that silence. Should be okay for now, but getting very low.
Yeah, Absurge jumps over to try and make Poike fake cast these heals. Peekaboo sneaks in with a full kick, though. That could just be the end of the game. Hellstone, he's dangerously low. Alec peels away with the Infernal. Poike hasn't been able to get a cast off. Now silenced by Peekaboo, looking to close out in an early game. Shadow Crash off the back of this Kidney Shot. Trinket Spear Link available. And Poike needs to be a bit wary in this position. Earthen Shield Totem was down right before that stun. It's stabilizing him. He's going to jump back to the pillar, try and fake cast the Wind Shears, and duck behind the corner. And Poike survives the initial attack of the
Yeah. Alex rotting down, though, as well as Nixie. Poike trying to stabilize. He's caught into the full blind. Is he going to trinket this? He trinkets. That could be his life a little bit later on that second Vendetta in 35 seconds. Alec taking an immense amount of pressure, though, as you can see Peekaboo and Absurge looking to really punish that trinket from Poike. Full Hex is going to be secured, but it breaks, unfortunately. But WizK is putting out pressure onto everyone.
Yep. Both sides are dipping dangerously low at this point. WizK does not want to go down without dispersing. He's in execute range. He's playing a dangerous game, but Absurge picks him back up. Now Poike stunned with no trinket behind the pillar, but Peekaboo is rotting down. How much longer can Peekaboo stay in the face of Poike? He's managed to get through the kick, connects one healing surge. He needs to be careful. He's running in line of sight of WizK. He gets silenced now. Peekaboo gets Stormbolt behind the pillar, catching Peekaboo off guard. WizK life swapping his health to Peekaboo, trying to capitalize and assist on that mistake by Peekaboo. I love the punish, though, if they're going to overextend, but Poike gets caught. He's in midfield. WizK can cast
it
on him. Nixie leaps over, disarms Peekaboo. Vendetta is ticking 3 seconds away from that astral shift. Will Poike choke in this position? He trades out the astral shift, jumps to the gate. He can make a getaway if he needs to, but he's playing a dangerous game, but Nixie's dangerously low as well. He might need to gate behind the pillar. Will Poike be able to pick his team back up with almost nothing left? Spear Link Totem, but Alec's not there. He's rooted too far away. His team is just rotting down. Nixie's so dangerously low. Poike holds on by a thread.
Kidney shot him in Poike. This could be it for The Move. They could take him down right here. Poike, how are you going to handle this situation? Nice Spear Link Totem coming in. Alec was there. That was so key for their team to survive. Silence out on Poike still. Just so much pressure coming in from The Move. Poike, he has to play like a god in this situation.
He has nothing left, and WizK's right in front of him, but Absurge gets fully hexed, but it breaks. Poike gets kicked. Peekaboo looking for the solo kill. WizK's Shadow Crash comes crashing in and takes them out. out. The move are all about aggression in this series, now leading the series 2-0.
And that Shadow Crash is gonna send Minpoike straight to the Shadow Realm. The move firing on all cylinders here. They had a rough go in their first series. They've managed to stay alive in this lower portion of the bracket, and they are trying to move on forward past this EU squad. They only need one more game to do it. And you can see, Zico, how confident they are right now. Peekaboo's gonna challenge everything, take absolutely every engagement.
I love when you see the confidence in Peekaboo's playstyle. This does not look like the same Rogue we were watching yesterday. These step kicks is so decisive. Very, very fast step kicks. He's on Minpoike the entirety of the game, putting up a Peekaboo actually come back behind that pillar and let Minpoike top himself up and top his steam up. So the move are just playing super aggressive, and Absurge as well, constantly in the face of his opposition. And
this tournament of Legion, who is going to come out on top? The move on their main classes, their main specializations, or is it going to be Tempo Storm trying to come out with the counter pick? This game can be enough for the move to move forward.
Yeah, Tempo Storm, the reigning BlizzCon champions, they're potentially on their last tournament game of Legion if they fall against the move here and now. And Peekaboo is going straight for the throat right after Minpoike in the opening stages of this match. Full stun into silence, already forcing a trinket and potentially even more. The pressure from Peekaboo is mounting. How will Minpoike handle this? They are finally getting some counter pressure on Whiskey, but he lands a double fear, trying to fear them off. Triple fear from Nixie. Now they need to get something rolling. Can they get the dispersion? Minpoike is just standing in center field, right in line of sight of Whiskey. It could easily be a throwaway if he's not repositioned very soon.
That was a disaster. Peekaboo actually got a DR kidney on Minpoike there, unfortunately, so that's going to cost him a little bit of time. Whiskey forced into the disperse. Minpoike is low, though. Peekaboo lands the interrupt. Everyone from Temple Storm is rotting down. Can they find the kill? Spirit Link Totem gets dropped out. Whiskey just needs to survive a little bit longer. You can see Temple Storm is flailing to live. Full blind Minpoike. Jamie getting lower and lower. He needs to survive a little bit longer. Do they have the follow-up, TC? That's the kidney shot. How is Jamie still alive? Silence on Minpoike, and that is going to seal the deal. The move 3-0, Temple Storm.
Oh my goodness. That is a huge win for the move, and they do it in style as well. We talk about the move finding their groove. I think they just found it in the very first series of the day. Elimination match. They have sent the reigning BlizzCon champions packing. And that man on the stage right now, WizKey, that Shadow Priest that was just able to handle all that pressure and still absolutely pump when he's got two classes that shred Shadow Priest apart like paper. He won his first game on land yesterday, and now he sends the reigning BlizzCon champions home on a composition that we know is kind of something that they specialize in. This is insane for the move.
Absolutely, and I mean, this is not really a super alt comp because Jamie, of course, is a main shaman. He plays a lot of Enhance and a lot of Ellie, so I would say that that is definitely his main. And then Poike on that rest of shaman, you can argue that that's an alt, but Nixie on the warrior has definitely been instrumental to their training grounds. This is what he loves to do. And here, Minpoike honestly does a big, big mistake right there. Trinketing out of that silence is gonna come down to the fact that he just has such a great team backing him up as well. It's really the synergy between Absurge and Whiskey that really allows him to shine like this and hold on to his cooldowns for a long period of time. And I mean, we can take a look here. We can see Absurge is super low on HP. He's just used his trinket. You see Jamie, Nixie, everybody on the side of Temple Storm are just rotting down here. And Minpoike, of course, trinketing in that opener is gonna suscept him to that full blind. So all the move has to do here is to make sure that they get everybody on the side of Temple Storm low with that Shadow Priest damage, and then they can find that full blind, and then they can really, really sink that damage in onto Jamie or onto Nixie, whoever they prefer. Blind's gonna be followed up with that full kidney shot. Whiskey moving in position to follow that up with a silence as well. And I really wanna commend Jamie here for leaping over to Absurge, avoiding.
Indeed, I am now here with Peekaboo the man, the move finding their groove and taking out his old sponsor Tempo Storm. What do you feel like was the difference between today compared to yesterday?
I think yesterday we were just really uncomfortable with our comp picks and just kind of lost our confidence in ourselves and our faith in our comps and how well we could actually play. So I think we just decided to wargame a lot more people and play a lot more teams, and I think it helped us regain the feeling that we actually have the ability to win. So
Indeed, finding that confidence and more war games to practice definitely helps a lot. And was that how you were able to dismantle Tempo Storm today?
Yeah, I think so. I think our comps are really strong in what they play, and we've been kind of asking people, you know, what are they playing, what are they good at, what are they main, and I think we just had good comp picks in Domin. I don't think they really had an answer for us.
Indeed, I mean 3-0 in them, they definitely did not have an answer. And are you feeling confident now moving on to the rest of this tournament?
Yeah, feeling a lot better than I did yesterday. Yesterday was like, okay, maybe we don't belong here, but I think now, I think we actually might have a chance now. So.
There you go, NA's good ho peekaboo with the move, just slaughtering EU right now. Back to you, Rich.
Yesterday, Joe, on his